Okay, so that's set. Good. Finally put this up. Minimize this here. Turn that over. It's here. Whoops, gotta move myself. Move this here. I'm gonna have to re-edit that, aren't I? Alright. Go to paste bin. And then. Whoops. Let me go. Here, and. Where is my lol stats? I'll just copy this, put it in the paste bin, and close this here, just so you guys see what I'm doing, for anyone in League. Take the status, make sure you delete everything in there. Keep holding delete. You gotta make sure everything's gone in it, otherwise it looks really funky. In which case, click off, click back. It's all still there, what the heck? I think I broke my own status bar. Pentas, KDR. Assists. That should be everything on there. Says that it's off. Oh goodness. What the heck? It should all be gone. Unless, like, you have to rewrite over it, in which case now I'm nervous. Either way, here. Click it once. Take it, select what you want it to say. Drop it on in. Boom, now it should say live playing Godus, in which case I will be playing Godus. Hey, what up? How's it going? You came on quick. I wasn't expecting that. I got out of work here at 6, and I was like... Or at 7, I was like, sweet, I'll get on, I'll stream a little bit, I'll get into the swing of things, and people, you know, come on in at 9, but, hey, you showed up way early, so, but, thank you, I'm not gonna decline you from hanging on out, by any means. Let me change this over to this, since that's max characters. Last, let me head on over to my Facebook and put this up. I've been doing, like, I was at work all day today, and I could not stop thinking about this game. I was just like, oh my goodness, what if I try doing this? What if I join doing this, getting around? I was looking up a lot of, like, on the Steam forums, and there is the problem still of the population cap. They should be fixing it here. I cross my fingers and say should be come Monday. With the weekend, I guess none of them were working. So, I don't know. But if that's the case still, I'm going to redo all my population or all my houses tonight. That's the goal for me. Do a little multiplayer battle. Duke it out. Have some fun. Worst comes to worst, if I don't get any cards from doing multiplayer... I'm going to scrap it, scrap everything I do, and I'm going to power through the game. I'm going to get, just expand as fast as I can, get to multiplayer, get to the questing or the story mode, and then I'm going to just start mining. I'm just going to dive headfirst into the mine and just keep my guys going so that I can get gems, so that I could buy cards that I'm missing. I also learned that as long as your people are on beautified land, they won't die. So, another way around population, pardon me eating while I talk, I know it's rude, but I'm starving. Way around the population cap is for like all my people that are on, and let me jump on all the way back. I left at a really bad spot this morning. Get 10k per, that's good. Let me get all the way here. So, with my population that's all at the sea, if I beautified everything, every single square inch of this place, all the way down, blah, 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 blah. Now I gotta wait till nighttime to beautify anything in the sand, so you can see it a lot better. But, in theory, I could take all the people that are in here, which there should be 12. Yep, I can take 12 people, and I think you're able to pull 5 out of it. In which case, I can pull 5 people on out. You can boost the population well past the 3,000 mark. And you should be good. Now, that's what they're saying, so indefinitely you can just keep making population until, I guess there's actually a memory leak that'll happen that'll cause your game to crash, and then you lose your game. So you have to start over brand new with a max population on your screen at a given time. Is it will just, you know, make your game crash and you lose everything. So it's a risk, but I don't know if I'm willing to take the risk here with, you know, Monday being right around the corner, and hopefully by the end of the day when I come home, there'll be some, you know, hot fix in it. I was looking through the program files in itself, trying to see if there's a way you can, you know, give yourself gems, or if there's a way you can give yourself whatever your god power is with my little gumballs. I was trying to see. Couldn't find anything in there. I don't have the necessary software editing tools to do it. But if you had the proper software, then technically you could fix the code in the game that limits you to buildings and just advance farther. They did not block the Bronze Age, actually. They said that you can get up to, what is the, some of the C. Let me flip on back here. This was by one of the mods on the forums, on the Godus forums, is you can get up to the Philosophical Age, you can't pass it. I guess they did block off, so you can get the Bronze and Iron, but you can't get to Philosophical. Which, I'm okay with. They're saying that the problem with Philosophical is that your game will just crash, and so they just haven't, I take it, coded up to that part. But it's not a big deal to me. I still just want them to fix the problem that I can't even get into Bronze Age. Now, I don't know. There's probably been people playing this all day today, which I wish I could have been doing. But I guess there's, underneath this mountain, right next to this vein, there should be, and I'm going to excavate it to find out, a coal vein that you can mine. Now, this is speculation of just what I've seen on some forums, but yo, relax. And so we're just gonna just take a look. Let's see if we can kind of clear this away, and I'm gonna just see if what I was seeing online is actually true. Layer by layer, we'll melt this place on away, and we'll see if we can get down to the coal, another possible mining resource. Now, supposedly also, though this is one gem vein, diamond vein, whatever you want to call it, there are others, is what another mod was saying, is, you know, there's not just a singular one. And even though this one is supposed to maintain you for quite some time, you know, of course there should be others, because what happens when you do mine this one all the way out? You gotta have something else to go and do, or another one to go and mine. But they really, from everything I was reading on the forums, they don't want to make it a pay-to-play game where they really want the gem store to be, you know, are you playing the game? Are you playing it a lot? If you're playing it a lot, we're going to give you more gems. More gems means that you can unlock more things. And also, they're saying that gems are not going to affect multiplayer at all, which is just exciting to myself because I hate games so much where it's like, oh sweet, I spent $100 on this game and now my gun one hits you and there's nothing that you're gonna do about it. You can kind of just suck it up and you're gonna die. So at least in this game, the only thing you really gotta worry about is the Finger of God, which is a totally broken skill, in my opinion. Absolutely bogus. But hey, I have yet to use it. I got it used on me as a test. It was not fun by any means. But supposedly, through all this garbly gook that I'm trying to tear through slowly but surely, there's supposed to be this coal vein mine section that I'm trying to get into. Now at 8 o'clock, I'm going to step out for just a moment. I'm going to have to put the garbage out so that the garbage dude can not complain at me anymore. That and my roommate. Oh, really? There's no one who's made it to Bronze Age? Because, I mean, this is just what they were saying on the forums, is you should be able to get there. What's card 57? What do we got? Oh, I don't even... 57. Okay, well, if card 57 is not available and it's needed, then maybe you can't. Maybe they're just lying on the forums. Well, you also gotta think this is... They just opened up the game to the masses. There's gonna be so many things that people are gonna go through, like... Bug number one, just loading the game in general, or having it just randomly crash when you break a piece of land. Like, there were so many bugs that I was looking on the Steam forums that and issues that people were having that are just normal. Now, they're, you know, I guarantee they're looking into it, but on Friday night, they probably left work like, all right, we're going to put this on Steam and get ready for a shitstorm. Because when you release it to thousands of people, and there have been a lot of people who have bought this game, but when you release it to thousands of people, what do you expect is going to happen? I mean, they're going to find errors, they're going to find bugs, they're going to find problems, and they're going to just come in on Monday and be like, well, let's get to work, sit down, and just start fixing things. So I'm excited tomorrow. We'll really see if they're going to address some of these issues. And, man, it was funny reading some of the stuff, though, where people are like, oh, hey, this is just... What is that? What is that? Yeah! What I read and saw wasn't just shenanigans. It is a resource hidden in here. Look at that. Look at this, which means that there should be coal. If I can delete this fast enough here... Okay, stop scrolling downward. I don't want to zoom in. I should have to delete three layers. One, two... Nope, just more of whatever this resource is. I don't even know. But, cool nonetheless. Start just deleting it away. Now, before I went to work, I did harvest a bunch of... whatever, prayer, god power, dream eater, gumballs, whatever you want to call it. I harvested a whole bunch of it, just so that I knew that I'd be using it when I got home. So, let's uncover whatever this white stone is, sulfur, whatever. I know that coal is right next to it, however. So, let me just keep uncovering, see how deep this rabbit hole goes. Yeah, it's not... They have multiplayer capability, but it is by no means, from what they were saying, like, this is the multiplayer game. Like, they're probably going to add... A, they're going to add a buttload more maps. Maybe what I'd really like to see is if they add player maps to it. If they added, you know, say I have a map that I've built, you know, they add a map editor to it, where you can create your own and have your friends download it, and they host it on their server, and then if it gets popular, then, you know, other players can play it. That would be super cool if they pulled something like this, the StarCraft mod ability where... Okay, no, go in. Or, no, if you mod it, StarCraft will then host it, and if it's popular, they'll keep it up, otherwise they take it down. That would be awesome. Yeah, but, you know, it just came out, they were running it in alpha, and, you know, the thing with beta games and how a lot of companies are doing it now is they're releasing, quote, early access, where you pay to play, and, well, you pay to play the game that they've made, but it's so hit or miss with the games, only because... You know there's going to be bugs in it. They're still working things out. It's a work in progress. I mean, they know they have issues. They know what they have to do. I guess they're just a team of 20 that's actually made this game, which is kind of cool. I mean, I guess a team of 5 could have made it in a few years, all said and done. Or if they really just sat down, they could have done it in a year. But, you know, it's still a work in progress. Goodbye, house. I have to redo this whole area anywho, so I don't really care. My house? No, you can be homeless. I am your god. Will do as I say. Fall into my pit. Mine my sulfur, you peasants. Which I don't even have mining capability unlocked, so look at my sulfur. I wonder how deep this actually goes. Uh-oh, Blake's home. Hey, what up, Blake? Where were you go chilling with, what, were you out with Andre or whatever? Move all this, get out of the way. Move it, I said to you. All right, give me 5 minutes. I was just saying if you went out with Andre and we're hanging out in the... Is that the drug tea? It's a little bit. Holy crap, dude. No, I'm good. I don't like tea in general, unless it's sweet. Yeah, I guarantee it's not sweet. I was gonna put it out in 5 minutes, but yeah, you can.
And I wonder just how deep the rabbit hole goes.
Okay, you are gonna just get deleted. I'm sick of you. Don't climb it. Oh, really? Nice. So, does he just live down here, or? Oh, I didn't want to expand that outward. Delete, 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 delete. Goodbye, mountainside. This will be my mining pit. I'll have all my Africans come in here. Blood diamonds. Okay. Oh, you mean guy as in guy? Yeah. Okay. So he's working now, at least. Oh, okay. That's awesome. Nice. And I'm just gonna delete all of this. I don't... Go away. Go away. I want to see all of you. Oh, how are you able to build a house on a sulfur mine? You're gonna die. You're gonna drink the water, and you are gonna die. Oh, by all means. I mean, I have a TeamSpeak if anyone ever wants to join it. I don't really care. I just can't promise anything. If you banned, it's... You get banned, I can't unban you. You gotta respect the admins that are in there, or they all have permission to ban and none of us ask questions. So by all means, I don't mind. And of course I have Skype as well, but they need to at least have like a chat system involved in multiplayer. Where, you know, you can do a little trash talk. You need it in every multiplayer game. But maybe in time. Hello there! How are you, sire? Show me your sulfur, cutie pie. I wanna see all of it. Goodbye, mountain. You've been demolished. And just continue to kind of peel this all away and just unveil Mount Rushmore. Maybe it'll have my beautiful face sculpted into it. Never know, you can hope and dream, can't you? Highly doubt it. They don't know what my face looks like. But I guess I could give them a file and they could put it in here. Maybe. Possibly. Probably not. Hello there, Cornelia. How are you? Continue to peel away this white gold mountain. I'm expecting like some Disney ride to be coming out of this thing. Like, oh, it's Thunder Mountain. Or Candy Mountain, Charlie. Gonna go to Candy Mountain. I have no idea, actually. I saw this on the Steam forums. Someone posted a picture, and I'm like, what the heck? And so I guess there's this one, which I have to assume is the sulfur. And then they also have another one that's right next to it, which once I uncover all this, I'll uncover the next one. It should be right here. That is coal. Now, that's my own personal guess. There was no one who seemed to know what it was on the Steam forums. But, you know, it's worth a shot, and I wish I had mining. And I'm so tempted to just start my game over and just hyper-build everything super fast just to get mining so that I can start getting the gems. Because if you have gems, you can just buy anything that you could really want. I mean, if I can't win it from multiplayer, I need to win one lumber and one mining pick. Oh, I bet you can mine it. Oh, for sure. But if I get one lumber and one mining pick, I'll have mining unlocked. So if there's anyone who wants to do a little multiplayer, let me know. Oh, there's 460 jewels in what? In this vein? All together? Oh, man. There's gotta be another vein somewhere. I'm gonna be that guy who just levels everything to the water just to find stuff. I'm gonna sit there and be like, alright, this mountain? Cool. That's gone. Let's see what's at the bottom of it. I'm gonna find another vein. I'm gonna be that guy who's gonna just find the other diamond vein, and then I'm gonna make a YouTube video on it. Everyone's gonna be like, oh man, I was the first, and I'm like, nah, sucka. Mm-mm. Holy crap. I've burned through a 100k of my influence power already. Just in digging this big old white turd out. What is going on? And how deep does this rabbit hole go? How deep does the rabbit hole go? Alright, this is ridiculous. Where are we at? I'm gonna show you a neat feature with the fact with my mouse. If I actually load. Okay, come on. Come on, I wanna edit my profile. Come on, mouse. There we go. Give me a second here. I'm gonna bind this so that I can just spin my thumb button and have it delete land. Because it's gonna be a pain to just right click it. Oh, what? Oh, super. Now my mouse just isn't gonna work in general. Awesome. Thank you so much, Rat7, for failing me once again. Super. Okay. Alright, cool. Cool. Maybe you'll load. Oh, maybe you'll just crash my whole computer. There we go. Oh, did you know? No, I didn't. I don't really care. Set this over here. No, I want to set that as my node 1 clockwise. Okay, really? I want to insert a hotkey. In which case, nope, nothing out, nope. Mm-mm. Okay. There we go, mouse 2. Save it for clockwise. And mouse 2, save it. Set, good, save. Garbage, we'll activate it, and in which case, now let's see. Nice. Look at this just melt away like butter. Yeah. Alright, super. I'm gonna keep this up, and then let's just start peeling away. Need some tunes. I feel like I'm missing music. Anyone got anything they want to listen to? I'm down for anything as long as it's not rap music. I mean, nothing against people who like rap. That's just not my personal style here. Peeling away, layer by layer, peeling away, cause I don't care. Uh-oh, I think somebody died. Batman! Okay, get out of my way, houses. There's no time for houses. I am God here, and you will obey me, you peasants. How deep do you go? That's my question. I wonder if it just goes into the water, and in which case this is just like a big monument thing. Fistful of nickels? Alright, let's see what we got, Abrix. If this is a terrible song, I'm gonna shun you for life. Or just judge your song choice, that's all. I'm just gonna dig it into the water. Alright, whoever can guess what I'm drinking, I will buy them this game. You only get one guess, though. If anyone can guess it, I will buy them Godus. Alright, what do we got here? Dang, this thing's still going down! There's no way I'm uncovering all of this. This is shenanigans. These guys are eventually just gonna drown. There's nothing I can do about it, they're just gonna drown. Wait, is that a bottom that I saw, or is that just sand that I'm gonna see down here? I think that's just a sand layer. Nope. Another sand layer. Yep, there's water. So it looks okay. This thing needs to looks as if it just goes into the water. I'm just gonna continue to peel away. Pepsi, Diet Dr. Pepper, nope. Although I could have been. Good guess. I do have some Diet Dr. Pepper. Oh no, not anymore. I have Diet Mountain Dew. It's my roommate's, not mine, not by choice. Pepsi, I'm a Coke drinker myself. Sorry for anyone out there who's a fan of the Pepsi. It works. I'm not a... Oh, Budweiser. Man, I I don't drink beer. Not a fan. Not a fan. You can call me a girl, whatever you want. That's fine. Like the rest of my buddies, just harass me for not drinking. But I don't like the flavor. In which case, if it doesn't taste good, I don't put it in my mouth. Well, can you mine it? That's the only question. I mean, I'm just gonna uncover it, cause you know, who knows? Maybe inside lies all the secrets to the Bronze Age. Now, if I'm not mistaken, however, to make iron, you need coal, tin, and copper. In which case, if this is a tin mountain, and I know next to it, if I start to uncover all of this, just start eating this away, I should find coal. In which case, maybe it's something that's gonna be needed in future ages, possibly. Or if you need to hit the Iron Age, then you need to, or steel. Steel's made by tin, copper, and coal. Just forgive me. If I can peel this land away, good golly. Alright, so I will agree with people who say that this game is similar to Farmville, where you just do a lot of clicking. Yeah, I mean, again, this is all speculation. There's nothing out there on what's right, how to do anything. This is all just kind of winging it, doing your own thing at this point. There's no right or wrong in this game at the moment. Okay, seriously, just keep peeling it away. Peel away. Peel away. Peel away. Okay, I need to move this mountain so that I can actually see what I'm getting into. Move this back away. Find me some more creativity space. I know my coal is here. I know. I can smell it. I can smell ya, boy. I said, boy. Get out my way, mountain. What are you doing here? You're covering up the beautiful... Oh my gosh, it's a face! Look it! It's a face! Holy tits, here's the forehead, here's an eyeball, here's a nose, here's the mouth. Holy shit. Pardon my French, but it is a motherfucking face. I need some sculpting music. You're right. Who sent that link? What do we got? This is opening up. OC remix. So far, I'll take it. It is a motherfucking face, man. This is awesome. This is so cool. Get out of my way. Move, mountain. Move! I will shred thee with my god power! And this makes me want to turn on another artist that I have that does similar stuff. I don't know. We're going to find out here. If I got to spend all 100K just to uncover it, I'll do it. This is sweet. This is intense. Got a face just chilling. Alright, so that's good. Peel some of this way in here. I'm looking for now a neck, maybe. See if it continues on outwards here. This reminds me of like some Zelda Epona music. I feel like Indiana Jones right now with this The tune's playing. I feel like I'm in an old western. I'm uncovering buried treasure from pirates. Really, it's just a face, but this is awesome. This is so cool. And this, people were like, man, this game is... Kerbal Space Program, that game, so much fun. Anyone who doesn't have Kerbal Space, you need to go on out. Uh-oh, here's a... looks like a neck coming out of it. Okay, I'm sorry, Mountain. I'm sorry, house up here. You guys are... you're gonna die. You are being sacrificed. But this is what is awesome about this game. Is all these, like, really weird things. And I was reading on the Kickstarter that if you were to back them, like, you could make these things, or you would be an Easter egg in the game in itself. Like, this is cool. I don't care if I get, you know, nothing out of it. The fact that I just uncovered a face in a game is just awesome to me. I feel like I'm on Mars and I just discovered that there was, like, human life on there. And by all means, if you ever want to watch me play Kerbal Space, it is the most screwed up thing. I've yet to touch the moon in Kerbal Space. I don't know how people can do it. I can barely get into space with a rocket that has any fuel left to go anywhere. Let me see your earlobe. I want you to see the bottom of your ear. I wonder if this person's got a round head or is just flat in the back. I'm hoping it's flat in the back. I got a big old round noggin. This is gonna suck. This is gonna be a lot of digging. In which case, there goes all my funds. Uncovering this face just took away all my funds for expanding my population. So tomorrow, I'm gonna have to just do work in the game. But by all means, tonight will be a night of fun. Clearing away. Oh, sorry, fellas. Yeah, you just got the short end of the stick. Moving on out. Moving on up. Moving on up. Break me off a piece of that Kit Kat bar. Okay, I wanna build entire mountains. There we go. Nice. That's what I want, game. Yes, move my mountain. Take the click. I wish I really just could, like, reach into the game and be like, oh, that's cool. Now I'm just gonna shred all of this and just, like, put my finger on there and touch each individual layer. Just move it as far back as I wanted. Well, sorry guys, you are now gonna go join your ancestor in the Pit of Doom. Just think, at least you're not in the Thing of Snakes, like Indiana Jones was. And he hated snakes. You can go and, you got water down there, you can go and take a drink. Okay, so I'm gonna expand now and see this thing's neck. In which case I'm probably, yeah, I'll just start doing this and start shredding away the mountain here, layer by layer. Although having scroll wheel doesn't necessarily make it register that you're trying to delete it, so you have to still scroll, but you gotta, or you can still scroll, you just have to do it really slow. Because we try to do it too fast, it's like, whoa, what are you doing? So if you have a scroll wheel on your mouse, which I don't know any mouse that wouldn't, then you can just bind it to your right click. Okay, really, thanks game. Please don't crash. Nice! And then you can just kind of carve away these areas pretty quickly. Quicker than normal. Although still, you know, grabbing multiple things of land is still faster. But in my case, yesterday freaking killed my wrist. I have yet to... Uh-oh! Uh-oh! What is this? A shoulder blade? I see you. I see you, stone. Oh, I will uncover you. Oh, you're so tricky. You tried to hide from me. Oh no, I only have 49k. I'm never gonna make it. Someone lend me your gumballs. I want to uncover all of this. I'll never be able to though. Looks like a shoulder blade. Uh-oh. Which really makes me wonder, is there a whole body all down through here? Oh no. Oh, thank goodness. I almost lost my statue. I would have just cried. I'd be freaking crying tears of blood right now if I lost that statue. So let me just keep on digging. Keep on keeping out. Although, give me one second. I liked that song, in which case, let me load up. And anyone who wants to take a listen to the playlist. Whoops, I guess change it. But Andy McKee is the individual's name. So we'll just play some really just light stuff. He plays everything just on the guitar all by himself, so out of the way, rocks! I said move! And on the seventh day, God found a statue of another human being on his planet that he thought he had created, in which case he put a statue in the middle of it to embody himself. So now I'm interested to see here, because they have like Noah's Ark and Jonah and the Whale, at least those are my personal opinions on it. Nothing of definite yes or no. Okay, and I gotta be real careful with peeling too far back over here, because I don't want to touch into my gold vein or my gem vein. I mean, not that you can actually delete it, maybe. But someone brought up a good point that I saw on the forums, is what happened if you just saved up all of your prayer, like all the people that have been worshiping you. You saved it all up until you had the finger power, and you killed every single one of your people. So if I went through and took everyone out of the homes, smashed all of them, put them all to the coast, and then made a whirlpool and killed them all, would the game then be over? Because you need to have a population to continue playing. And in which case, you wouldn't have a population. So then, would you just break the game? Would they give you a new population? Would they give you a new map? Would they just tell you to restart? Because in the game, there's not a way to just click new game. So he brought up an interesting point that I wonder, and maybe, you know, after they do a reset of the game here, I'll go through and try it out, but it was cool in theory, cool thought. If you can actually end your own civilization's life. Come on, shoulder blade, why you be so difficult? I just want to see your whole body, lady, or guy. Oh, go away. Recede, I say. It's like I'm shaving. I'm shaving this individual's sandy beard away. Go away. I'm guessing, though, that this is the end of it down here. Uh-oh. I'm getting dangerously close to screwing with my gold trail. Not that I can actually utilize it anyhow, so I guess it's not really a super big deal, but Peel it away. So, okay, it is. Looks as if this is gonna be the last section of it down here. But. Indiana Jones and the freaking Raiders of the Lost Ark, man. What's going on right here? Slowly just tear it away layer by layer now. I gotta find the end of this thing. So there's at least part of the end. Start peeling it away, layer by layer by layer. Oh snap, I gotta talk to my roommate in a moment. There's an attractive blonde chick in my complex that she's out walking her dog today. I gotta tell him my story, my little endeavor with her. Probably has a boyfriend, in which case I'm a coward and I wouldn't go and initiate a conversation anywho. Though I'm a salesperson, is my job. Talking to people outside of work is not my strong suit by any means. Yeah, I gotta wonder if there's other statues. I mean, it makes me want to just find the next biggest mountain and just continue to dig downward. But that's the thing with this game, like, people are still going to be uncovering cool new things that no one knew of. So that's what I'm doing. I saw someone that just was like, what's this? And they just posted the photo of the top of it. And as I thought it was sulfur, I was way wrong. And I'm glad I was wrong, actually. Which you don't hear often. Not many people are gonna admit to being glad they're wrong. You can't get rid of them if you rebuild the ground. So if I technically took this down to water, and then I rebuilt even a single layer, they'll be back. I just did PvP versus the computer. And what, they came back? Outward. Now, what should the statue's name be? That's the question. So that's as far as it goes here. It's because every statue needs a name. But is it a guy? Is it a girl? Am I gonna name it after, you know, some other god? Because this is like a previous race that's clearly been here before my people have gotten here. But. Nice. So then maybe there's a way where you can mine all of the yellow ground, like all the gems, and then go into player, or like player versus player, or the player versus computer, and get more gems. Worth a shot. But overall, this is my beautiful lady. She is now all built. Well, not all built. I guess technically her ears are still hidden. Or part of her ear, I guess. But. Ah. So it's there, but your miners are like, eh, we're lazy. It's not actually there. I wonder, now, the question is there two phases? Is this kind of like Lord of the Rings, where there's like the water in the middle and they have one god on one side representing good, one side on the other side representing bad? And did I just find the good god? I don't know. More excavation is going to be needed. That's all I know. And just keep digging. Just keep digging, digging, digging. Oh gosh, I don't even have meteorite unlocked. So if you can meteor strike your guys, by all means, it's the only way to really, you know, have your people listen. And you know, the finger of God is the easy way to punish your people. However, the real way is with meteor strike. Something that looks natural. Oh goodness. Now, did it crash and kick you out? Or did it just crash in and then you can get back in? That's the question. Okay, keep on digging on. 14k left. Probably have 10k in my one town that I first started with. Reveal some of this guy's noggin. Let's set here. Whoops. Moving some of those layers, shave it on down. Sorry, house. On this day, you, I'm just gonna do this, because I know I'm gonna have to eventually do it. Just kinda expand it all out. Now what I'm really tempted to do, this is gonna be like a full day endeavor, is make everything just sand level. Delete every single thing until it is all sand level, and see if I can find any more cool things like this statue face. But that's a goal for later on. First I gotta get past my population limit and wait for a bug fix on that. Then we can go farther. Delete some of this now. Alright people, why are you chilling next to the face? I know, it's absolutely amazing. I'm still fascinated at the fact. But yeah, I don't know. I don't think that there's any photos of the future ages per se. I don't think they've released anything. So, I mean, they're still making the game basically. They probably have people that are fixing the issues, and then they have other people that are just continuing the advancement. Oh no! Cracker Jacks. I wasn't paying attention. I ran out of gumballs. I'm gonna have to just harvest every little bit. Get to listen to some Mozart. Because supposedly, I guess this is one of his tunes. Whoops. No, it's gonna stop. Means, oh, you suck at continuing music. I'm a bubblegum chewer. I chew lots of bubblegum. Let me eat all your gumballs. make your god happy by giving me more gumballs. Oh, thank goodness I almost missed that one. Alright, 41k. I think I can make do with that. 41k is not bad. Let's see. Where's the big face? I want to see the big face! Okay, you ask it, I shall give you the big face. And this, sir, is the big face. So this is what we have here. Yep. Been slowly uncovering it. It's a work in progress. Just slowly scraping away every little tidbit I can. I see that it's in the water. I wonder, because I see that it goes into the water, if it actually goes to, per se, the bottom layer of water. That's my question. Or maybe there's a weird thing if you uncover all of it, like it stands up or comes back to life or opens its eyes. I don't know, something crazy could happen. You never know. Some coder could have been like, oh hey, let's freak everyone out that ends up actually finding this face. It's a cool thought to myself. Sup, Dump? How's it going, man? Move this on back so I can see its neck a little bit better. Peel it away here. Yeah, I can. So you can see the face. And then just everything. The only thing is you just can't edit anything from this, but overall an absolutely massive head. I mean, this is gigantic. In which case I'm gonna create like this moat around it, where in case any peons of my peasant population tries to go and touch my predecessor, they'll die. Peel this all back here. The whole face, if I can zoom out here, if you actually own the game yourself here, right where this totem was, this was a big mountain. This was the highest peak mountain I think that you can get. And no, I did not get the Bronze Age yet. In which case, I just started digging down and I found this section here. So just imagine it filled in around the earlobe, and then all of a sudden I got down to like this part, and as soon as I scrolled down, I just was like, what the it's a face! And like, here's its forehead, you can see from all the veins. I thought it was a sulfur mine, I thought it was something that, you know, you could harvest, but it's not. But yeah, I haven't. I'm still waiting for mining. I need lumber and one other, and a mining pick, and then I can finally start mining. But I doubt that I'm gonna win those from a multiplayer game, and in which case I'm just probably gonna start a new file. I'll probably do it come this weekend, in which case I'll just power run through the game and just unlock mining so that I can start mining gems, basically. And once I can start mining some gems, then I can buy everything else that I need to hopefully advance faster. Okay, Come on, ground. There we go. Get eaten away. Eat away, eat away, eat away, eat away. Okay, so there's my water layer. I just want it to be all watery. I just want water all around my statue, that's all. Uh-oh. What the heck? There's more under the water! Look at it! I saw this little bit pop up! As I eat away the water, it's still there! This statue probably goes all the way to the ground. Oh, man. I'm down to play some multiplayer. Down for a little 1v1 action. As long as we don't use the Godfinger bogus, then we're good to go. The only thing is I'm starting to peel into my diamond funds or gem funds by peeling this away, but hey, you know, it's the price you pay for exploring. Let me know when you're all loaded up and we'll duke it out. So that's good. Looks like a little cheekbone down here. Okay, but let me, that's all revealed. I'll come on through and reveal this section of its shoulder, which should be all set. In which case, I'll just kind of delete all this up in here. One of these days I'll dig it all the way down to nothingness and see if anything connects on over. Oh, maybe I'll just do it with this section here. Seems to be working pretty well. Digging on down to nothingness. Now, is it actually? Okay, so it you can sculpt all the way around the sculpture. Now, I wonder if I wonder if you sculpt all the way around the sculpture, or like the statue, if it'll be like your totems where the whole thing will sink downward then. Now I'm curious. Oh golly, sorry for the song to play. This shouldn't be here. That song is in the wrong playlist. Start peeling this away here and just get down to water on the entire statue. And then I'll probably have to rock some multiplayer in between. Because I have to wait for my dreams, my prayers that I can harvest. Because I don't have any to go and harvest. So let me spend my 26k, and then if anyone has the game and wants to do a little multiplayer duking it out, I'm so down. Move all this here. Scrub is a guy, won't get no love from me. Chilling on the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. Sorry, I'm done. I promise. Now, I would play some Ludacris because that guy is hysterical in his raps. He doesn't take any of it seriously. Okay, I'm gonna move this whole thing back. That way I can move the whole top of the head. Is anyone looking for a cell phone? If you're looking to buy cell phones, that's my area of expertise. Not that I can actually sell them to any of you, but if you're looking for deals on him, I know where to go. Don't worry, they're all physical places. There's no online deals. Keep peeling on away. Good, that's what I like to see. I like to see this water all the way around. Oh, goodbye house. Sorry, fella, you just got boned. Sorry, on this day, God said, nope, you aren't gonna live in that house anymore, and I'm not actually gonna provide you a new one. You're just gonna have to move and Dor probably die. Sorry, life sucks. You know what they say, when life gives you lemons, you find a new god. And in which case, you could try to find a new god, but in this game, I am your god. You can take it or you can die. This here, 17k. I should be able to expose all of it. I got a majority of my mountain destroyed. I mean, I started doing this whole endeavor with 250,000, and now, oh geez, I have no idea. I'm a Verizon sales employee, so I work for Verizon. Some wireless phones. So, eventually we're supposed to be getting Fios into the area, which is nice, but dump, I'm not clicking that. That's probably the Teemo song. I don't feel like listening to the Teemo song. Actually, if it's the Teemo song, I'll probably listen to it, because it's a great song. Nope, I'm not click. Nope, good, that's not. I'm not, don't click that link. Don't click it. It's a terrible video that you've probably never seen and don't want to see. No, I'm not playing that song. I'm not playing that song. Everyone who has Fios absolutely loves it. I haven't talked to a single person who's like, man, my Verizon Fios sucks. Never have I heard that come out of someone's mouth. Like, anyone who has it just rubs it into everyone else like, oh, hey. Guess what you don't have, and I do. It's like, wow, I want to kill you. I'm not gonna play the Fox song, alright? If you guys want to listen to a terrible song that is mildly funny, by all means, click on the link that Dump sent. Otherwise, don't. It is the Fox! I clicked it! Look, Dump, you want to know what's great? Is I can click your link, and you ready for this? I have two monitors, so I can see the link without showing everyone else. You big goofball. So I'm not playing the Fox song. I bet you didn't know I rocked double monitor, did you, Dump? Trying to pull a fast one on me. No, no, no. Not to my house. Well, if you guys... Here, you can take a little look. I don't really care. I think that changes it to both my monitors. Should, anyways. Nope. I guess I don't have it set up. Scene 2. There we go. So you can take a look, see that this is what I have for both my monitors. So I just run the Twitch stream on one. If you play the Teemo song, if you link me that, I'll play the Teemo song. I don't mind it. But just got music always playing. And then in which case, this is me. I was trying to look through... Whoops, not that one. As I was looking through the Godus files, and I was looking like, these are some commands that you have that are just native, where if you don't want to, I guess just use your mouse, or you just want to rock just hotkeys for multiplayer, you can just click it rather than scrolling through on the God Power list. So that's kind of cool. And then down here, it just gives really simple things, which I don't know. I was trying to mess around with the groups, which seems to hold the amount of chests that are on the map at a given time, the amount of diamonds or gems that are on the map, was looking around with that, but really, these are all your files. And I don't know, I was messing around with them earlier this morning, just before I went off to work. So, what do we got? All right. Ding, 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 ding. The only thing I don't like about the song is it's like, it sounds like Timo's just enjoying this way too much. Dang, this thing goes really far. Out of the way. This guy's got a big cranium. Move yourself. Fear not the man's cranium, but the brain inside. In which case, you really gotta fear both. I only have 5,000 left. Alright, who's ready for some multiplayer? Oh shoot, I'm still rocking with my double screens, aren't I? Yeah, here. There we go. Oh, do you really? Alright, if you want to listen. So I have my own voice that does... It does Timo, I guess. It does him some justice. But it doesn't do as much justice as the voice changer I have that makes me sound like a squirrel. It makes me sound like Timo, more or less.
Never underestimate the power of the Scout's code.
Well, that was my own voice. But... So that should have been the changer. Should have been. Okay, so it did work. So there's the voice changer for you. No, I'm not gonna keep singing it. You can listen to the song in itself if you want. Otherwise, you can find me the lyrics. I will keep the voice changer on and I will sing it myself. And I will send you a video of it if that's what you want. But anyone on a multiplayer, so far this is the entire face. As you can see, I have it dug pretty far out. And anytime I try to actually like zoom out to view it, I can't. It forces me to zoom in to this lower level. But this is the face that has been uncovered here. It is some goddess. I need a name for this goddess. I don't know what I want to name her yet. I would name it something really cheesy like Helena of Troy, but I don't like it. I want something a little bit different. If someone wants to multi Cornelia, I think of Cornelia though, and I think of like Master Chief and Halo. I can't. This game isn't like a Halo game to me. I can't do it. Well, I see that it's your name, but I still think Cornelia, Cortana, it just associates. I can't do it. I need something different. I need an old name that is powerful in itself. I would say something like Lucretia. But she doesn't seem like an evil individual to me, and I think of Lucretia as being something evil or mischievous. This seems like a very passive individual. I don't know. I would say something like Joan, maybe? The sleeping slut. I can't go Ash or Ezreal because then I'm bringing League into it. And I personally don't find the League names to be anything like very elegant or anything that would fit into this time period of prehistoric age. Why not just name it like, I don't know. I can't even think of any good names right now. This is just depressing. I almost have the whole head dug out though. I'm so excited. Nice. There's the water I'm looking for. So I'm gonna have to move all of this up here. When I have 15k, I'm good, I can do it. Okay, sweet. Move this here. Move this. Oh, it was great. My boss today, he's supposed to come in at 12 o'clock. Now, he's my district manager, or he's my market manager. So he manages 3 stores in total. But this is the second time he's done this to me. Is it like 12 o'clock? He texts me, it's like 12:30 now, and he's like, oh yeah, by the way, I can't come in because my car isn't working. And he's like, I can be in like 2 hours, and I'm just like, oh, dude, don't even bother. So twice now, he's just abandoned me. I mean, granted, he's paid me 10 bucks extra every time. But here's the face of this goddess, Cornelia. I love Diana. I'm a huge fan of Diana. That if I ever make a chick name, like if I'm ever in like an RPG or an MMO and I have a chick character, it's always Elizabeth or Diana, period. Those are the names. I don't run anything else. And if it's ever a guy, it's Zella or Sir Alexander or something based off myself. I could take a Diana. So I don't know. I mean, I found it was... I wish I could cover it up with my hand. Just imagine just below the ear to the edge of the lip, and then the nose is covered, and like this top section has been uncovered. I saw this on a Steam post, and then they had the black aspect of this revealed. Now, in the middle was still a mountain area. And they're like, oh, cool, I found resources. And so, further upon digging, this is not resources. This is a face. And in which case, I know what I'll be doing tonight is I'll be editing this section of Twitch feed. And I'll be posting it onto my YouTube channel that is just going to, you know, say goddess face. Something to keep an eye out for. But now I'm gonna go and just rebuild some populations and try to get this number back up as high as I can. I've been destroying so many houses that I gotta rebuild. Yeah, I mean, I could run Diana. I'll probably keep it as Diana. But give me one moment. I'm gonna go just chat with my roommate real quick and then just gonna figure out an area that I wanna demolish. It's probably gonna be all of this area. I'm just gonna straight demolish everything here and push everything forward and keep my statue up above and just try to get as many houses in the area around it as I can. But I'm so jealous. If I had 1500 jewels right now, because of you saying that, I wanna just restart this game. I want to just unlock mining, because if you have mining, you can just go into the book and you can be like, blah, 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 where are we at? Okay, so we go here and it's like, sweet, mining, we need 1 pick and 2 lumber, so I have to win possibly 3 multiplayer games to possibly even a chance to get this. But you go into the store with your 1500 jewels and you're just like, oh, that's cool, this sulfur stone card. Let's find it here. And then just buy it with gems, and you have there's 30 gems. You have 1,500. You buy 6. You unlock the card. You continue on into the next age. We look into the next age, and we're looking for, you know, a pickaxe and some coal. We're looking for furs and something else. Like, you can advance so fast. Athena. Ah, oh, that's a genius name. But that's so... you can't do all the steps. It will forcibly stop you. And it's not, this isn't PvP. Don't think of Mount of the Gods as PvP. Think of it as a story mode. In your story mode, you have to unlock the Bronze Age first before you can battle into it. So you can do up into it. And with getting the cards here, you get gems at each stage. Bonus gems, I should say. And, yep, and then PvP is actually taken care of at this building over here, in which case you click it, it basically turns on your ability to PvP, like what you would connect to and how the two are going to communicate, and then you would kind of select the person that you want to battle. So I know I was fighting Geeky Meerkat last night, and, you know, then you would just select it and you could battle it out. Let me harvest my little gumballs. Whoops, I didn't want to ring your doorbell, but... Oh, those guys. They're dragging on. Pop all these. Amy, how you doing over here? You good? You chilling with all the mountain people? Because I decided to stick you because you're a loner and I don't like you very much because you talked like a retard in the story mode. You didn't know how to type like a normal individual. You had to use terrible LOLs and XDs and ugly faces the whole time. It drove me mad. Whoops, I rang a doorbell. Ding dong ditch! Your god calls. Then he ran away. He ate your gumball and left you. Better harvest all these before I end up destroying them. Oh no! No! Rebuild! Thank the heavens. Oh golly. I hate that. That was a bad day. 61k? Sweet. Alright, I got mining before getting stone cottages and the science card after. The music's so nice. I'm just a stickler for like, oh my gosh, I gotta keep it going. I gotta keep it going as long as I can because I wanna hear that high pitched note. Like, that's just me. But I love it. Look at that. Look at Athena. Diana and Athena. Either one. Still caught between them. But let me anyone have the game? Wanna do some multiplayer here? You know, if not, I'm just gonna start wrecking my land, wreaking havoc, and just I guess rebuilding kind of my population. And try to get some bigger buildings in here. So if anyone wants to do some PvP before I start sculpting my earth again, just add me on Steam. And of course just tell me you added me. Adding me on Steam is One Nut Wonder. Same as my stream name. The O is actually a zero. And everything else is of course the same. Clear this out here. Get this set. And push this all in. Oh, hold on. Place my totem up here. That way when I start destroying houses here... missing. I'm gonna bring this whole section all the way up to the mountainside. That way I'll just clear this out here. And it'll be like a stepping stone for anyone who is gonna go and mine up there. Just have to step up to the mine, which should technically be on the ground level. And I may actually sink it down to the water. Okay, go for it, man. And I won't ghost on your stream, I don't care. If you wanted to, if we do end up battling and you want to TeamSpeak or Skype it, I don't care. But I'm vocal when I play. I broadcast all my moves so that people know if they end up getting the game kind of how I fight, and then they kind of tweak my fighting ability and my style. And oh, but the guys who just walk around from the statue are like tax collectors. If you think about it, they're just collecting prayers. They're God's tax collectors. It's fantastic. God took his mighty pointer finger and lands were moved. I sculpt this world to how I see fit. So that's as far as I'm gonna go here. Scared of losing my statue, because I lost one already when I was trying to sculpt everything, so I don't want to lose another one. Absolutely not. Just keep on keeping on. Oh, I almost forgot. I'm also going to need you to go ahead and come in on Sunday too. Wait, what? What are you talking about? Yeah, I have it. The big stone head is right here. So, there's a little spinorama view. Here's its face. I would bring it back farther, and eventually I'm going to put all my gold vein, whatever you want to call it, onto the base level. No, you didn't get anything. Just a big, like, adrenaline rush, like big boner. Like, oh, look at his face, it's so cute. But nothing unlocked, no population boost, no card found, nothing fancy, just a big old stone cranium. I'm interested to see if, you know, if you dig it all out. Oh, turns out I missed a spot. Oh, I can't. Really, it's not gonna let me. Okay, cool. So I have to do it from this way. I'm interested to see if, you know, you dig everything out underneath it, like with totems and stuff, if you dig out one layer on them, so say with like this, you dig out one layer and the whole thing will shrink downwards and go to the next level. I wonder if you're to do that with the statue, if I was to bring it all down to the very base level, which as you can see I started digging on down, if the whole thing will drop. Now I don't know if maybe the whole thing drops and it starts an earthquake, because this game seems to interact with the environment. I don't know, something worth looking into, but with only 34K, I mean, this took to just destroy the mountain and get to the face and uncover everything, it took 40,000 gumballs, prayers, dreams, whatever you want to call them. So, worship. I've had two grown men go into with my game and made a bunch of babies. I don't know. I'm like let me explain to you my grown men. I had Amy. She's chilling in this building. Now, if I spawn a child, it's a 50-50 chance that I see a girl come out. But this was just Samson or Simon or Dan or whatever the guy's name was. And every single time I open it up, there's another Dan. He just comes on out. It's like asexual. This guy's just sitting there and pops himself out like, oh, there's another me. There is another me. So I'm just going to continue to push all this back. You can point at the light all day, pal. Pointing's not going to get you anywhere. Now you can fall down and try to run to the light. But it's not going to help you any. Now I'm interested to see if the roads will actually spawn outwards. Okay, if I remove this, is it actually going to delete my diamonds or whatever? Oh, okay, I guess I can't even delete them. It doesn't let me. So push all this back. Oh, what's awesome is when you, like, redo the desert people, as I call them, everyone that's all down. I did this yesterday, I rebuilt all these. Ooh, gumballs. Is if you take everything here, and you can draw a line in the sand, and then make a small circle, and then you can set your beacon of light right next to it, so all the people will swarm, and then you just, boop, drag the ocean over, and everyone just drowns, and you just watch massive light just go up to the sky. It's like the whole Kool-Aid endeavor, when like everyone just mass suicided and drank the Kool-Aid, and it's a similar thing, except I drown all my people, because that's what I as a god had wanted, and my people listened. And on that day, they didn't get to go and ascend anywhere, they just died, and that was the end of it. But, you know, if they believe that there's another place outside of this, then they went there. But I have no heaven or hell in my world. It's either you do as I say and you live, or you don't do as I say and you die. And then your soul goes up to the sky, and probably your child ends up becoming you reincarnated. So. Way here. I'm gonna get as many forests as I can. Gotta get all them four territories. Now I'm just curious though, if they start building, if there's actually gonna be a road that like dips down and connects all these. I don't know. Because if we look at this one over here, this one has roads that connect up and around to here, but they don't connect. Ooh, I wonder. If I make a pathway. Oh no! No, stop it! Scariest thing in this game. Haha! So it does have a pathway all to these and now to the ones up here as well. Nice! Okay. So I do have a way over here. So, if this is the case, I'm gonna have to, these are all gonna be connected, but I'm gonna have to extend this out so that it can connect on this side. Nope. Come on out, piece of land. There you go. And then this little sliver. Alright, I'll keep that one up. Aw, what's wrong, Goose? I hate this golden beautification! Drives me brain crazy. Can't figure out what actual numbers on ground are. Why must this game be so shiny? I have to make everything so pretty. Uh-oh, I heard a four. This was a 4 that just happened. Maybe it was a 3 or a 2. Either way, this whole ground is being moved. Nice! So I crush a building to gain a 4. Okay with it. So I gotta rebuild these buildings anywho, since I'm at a population cap, and I guess at your population cap, your guys just decide to get lazy and stop building. The jewel stuff? Yeah. This stuff over here, you can absolutely mine it. Now, my dog's name officially is White Spot. However, his nickname is Goose. So. Yeah, you can judge me. You can judge me, it's okay. Everyone else does. Everyone's like, man, that's the dumbest name. So, yeah, it is. Okay. I need to move this totem over here. Go! Run! Run, my peasants! I command ye to run. Run for your lives. As your god forsakes your land. Crushes your houses. Your family shall die. Only after I harvest your gumball. And push it on up. Moving on up. How do you get your minions to start mining? Fantastic question. First, you unlock mining. And if I could, anyone who has the game and is just starting, I'm going to advise you to do that absolutely first. ASAP, get mining unlocked. Then, what you do is you will beautify the entire strip. By beautifying it, it draws your people to the location. After you beautify it, put out a totem of wandering. That will automatically call anyone in the area. So if you level all of this and just put all houses around, it will summon everyone to mine. And it will be like, you can see here, Anthony's been keeping up. He had 1,000 gems an hour ago. He's now at 2,100. Yeah, same. I'm looking for like multiplayer battles. I need one mining pick and 2 lumber thingamajiggies, and then I'll be good to have mining unlocked. And in which case, I can then make money and further my advancement towards the Bronze Age, which I guess no one has made it to the Bronze Age yet. Thankfully, but that's gonna be my weekend trip. Is I'm probably gonna delete everything that I've done so far. I'll somehow manage to save all these files on a flash drive. That way, if I ever wanted to go back, I'll have them exactly how they are. And so I'll have like my face uncovered and hopefully some other stuff. I'm gonna play this up until the weekend, or I really should say up until Friday. Friday's my day off. And then I'm going to start a new game, and I'm going to just power level it through, get up to mining, and once I get to mining, just, you know, AFK mine. So, that's the goal anyways for my plan. We'll see. Okay, Gumball, thank you. Sup? Ass hair titties? What? I don't know what the stars are. I have my filter on, so I don't see stars. Yo, I'm down for multiplayer. Zakes, if you want to add me on Steam, it's the same exact as my Twitch name, the One Nut Wonder. Feel free to add me. We'll duke it out. We'll play. I don't mind. Down for a little multiplayer brawl. Yeah, supposedly, now this is what a mod was saying before the game was released, is you can get to the Bronze Age and the actual age that he said you can't pass. Let me find it here. It's the Third Age. You can't get past Philosophical Age. The mod said that once you hit it, you are basically done. It doesn't let you. So, you can get to Bronze Age, you can get to Iron Age. I'm not sure if anyone has hit Bronze Age yet. Based off what everyone was saying, though, no one's getting past the population cap of the roughly the 2.2k where your workers just stop building and you have to do what I'm doing here and destroy your buildings and basically build anew. So that's what I'm doing here, and we'll see how it goes, if it actually works out and I can further advance. They try to encourage multiplayer so that you can get more cards so that you can unlock further in the advancement, but there's no set way right now to get into the Bronze Age. Probably. Well, if they're on beautified land, your guys won't die. So they can continue to try and mine on beautified land, and in which case they're gonna be okay. I'm not gonna have enough god power to finish up sculpting my land here, which goes up to do another small harvesting run, which I'd rather just do a multiplayer game, because you do multiplayer, you come back, you can harvest your big totems, there's another 20k there, and I'm good to go back to work again. But I'll take what I can get. If I gotta go harvest, then I gotta go harvest. It's over for me. That's all I got. Gumballs. I'm hunting for gumballs. Uh-oh. 300? Man, that wasn't even worth a click. Okay, that was worth a click. Every little click counts. But still, it's not what I want. I want big gumballs. Big prayers. Big dreams that I can go and eat. Bam, 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 bam. Best part about this game is just these little chimes and dings that you listen to. I absolutely love it. And then, of course, I get it to end there, but there's Amy's hut. Technically, that's Amy's hut in the back. That was just Amy's child. Sweet, 11k. That'll be enough to finish the sculpting and the remodeling of that area that I was just doing. So that's exciting. This will probably be my next project, is I'm gonna have... This was already done. I gotta have this all be done here. You gotta stop farming with these jewels. You gotta find a way to send them over to me, because I need about 100 of them, and I'm a happy camper. Because then I can mine for myself. But man, oh man. Man, oh man, I cross my fingers. Maybe multiplayer battle will give me some gems. Highly, highly unlikely, since it is randomly generated with your rewards, and everyone knows that random number generators for rewards suck, because they're definitely never in your favor. But I'll play multiplayer all night if it means I can get mining. If I gotta play freaking 5 hours of multiplayer to get my two lumber cards and a mining card, you got a freaking deal. Sculpting out this section here. And get in there! No, go away, you slug. I pour salt on you. There's all my fours. That should be good, but. There. No! Fill that in. Fill it in. sweet. Only because I'm a stickler for like straight edges in this game. There, good, good. Now, I'm gonna bring this sucker in. Don't destroy. In which case, I'm gonna bring this corner in, and that in a touch. So that should allow the roads to swoop down this way and connect. Should allow it to swoop down this way and connect. And in which case, I don't even have 10k to do what I wanted to do. And sadly, every time that this beacon is active, it's draining. So I'm gonna deactivate the totem. Let these guys go on out, build. Oh, I gotta activate it. Go back over here. I'm gonna totem over this way. And I'm actually just gonna do this. It's like creeping slime. Easiest way to destroy houses. Normally I would just finger have got it, but that's 10k. And ain't nobody got 10k right now. I know I do. So we gotta do it the good old fashioned way, just creeping slime it. Grab the green layer and just start swathing. If you're playing Risk, take one small army and you just expand it as much as you can to take out as much as you can. So, lobbing on out. Whoops. No one should be rebuilding right now. Who is rebuilding? Stop rebuilding the houses. I did not command you to. Your totem is active. You must follow the light like blind minions and do as I say. Good. Yeah, that's set. Yeah. Alright, sweet, let me. Now if either one, you know, wants to invite me to a multiplayer game, I don't mind. Duke it on out. I would prefer, before we do the multiplayer game, let me finish building these houses here. That way, oh, I should probably harvest this. Let me finish all these houses so that they're building while we fight, because the game still runs without you actually being there. So, like, while I was at work today, I was still gaining faith or prayers or gumballs, whatever you want to call it. So, if we go into a multiplayer game, it'll work the same, where I'll still be able to then come back in and harvest. In which case, spread out. We got 6,000 left. I can actually just take this one. I don't want two. I don't want a double blob. I want a single blob. Go away. Come down here. And spread on out this way. All of this, delete it all, right click it, shrink it all back, whoa, look at this lone house, trying to be a hero. Oh, sorry, heroes finish last in my world, there are no heroes here, I am God, I do not call for heroes. You will die. And the this all gets deleted here. I wish I could actually see the numbers that are on there, but I can't because I beautified the land first like an idiot. Which, if you beautify land, will make it so that your people don't die. So for everyone that's like near the water, you can beautify the land, and some people who have the population cap can just start spawning the people outside of their houses, and they'll just continuously wander around. Now, because they can wander around, you don't need to continuously build places, which are houses, which I guess caps around the 2.2k mark, which forces you to destroy your old buildings and rebuild, such as what I'm doing here. But, oh, really, I would be out of freaking faith. And in which case, you can have people just chilling. However, if you have people just chilling, like, this is what I'm talking about. I'll come down here. And this entire land is all beautified. If I blocked it off, made it one more so that they can't get out, people will continuously wander around here. And I can continuously just summon them out. And now each one of these things holds 12. You can put 6 people out of it. Or possibly 7. I do believe it's 6, though. And you can spawn those people out and they'll continuously walk around. But eventually you will get a memory leak error, which every time you try to load into your game will automatically crash where you need to start a new file. So it's a risk that you take on your own, but some people have taken the risk and it's been successful. One person got a population up to 4,000, but then his game crashed, and when he loaded it back in, it didn't save, in which case he then only went to 2,000 people, and then he started basically where he left off. So it's not worth it. Oh, if I had the meteor capability unlocked, which, if we take a look, I don't even have it. 10k, I would do it. I'd drop a freaking meteorite in my people. I'm just that kind of guy. My guys would be like, oh, hey, we're just going to run over here now. And I'd be like, oh, really? You're just going to run over there? Oh, you're just going to run into a meteor strike. You're dead. See you later. You won't be missed because you're hated amongst everyone. Because I influence them that way. Everything in here. In which case, that house is going to be destroyed. It's okay. I still have to redo that whole upper section. Anywho, which will probably be next. But I may go do over by Bertha, by the birthing place. Whatever that area is. I don't even know. The fertility building? I don't know what you want to call it. The one that's got a big baby coming out of it. That's all I need. Push this in. I want a straight line. Ah, it's close enough. I want a straight line. Straight. Yeah. And on the fourth night... I'm gonna have to do this, aren't I? Because it only expands from the road out to these places. Alright, deactivate! Go, 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 scatter! Scatter! Build! Build! Oh, I know that. Oh, shoot. I gotta move my head up. I know that it only works, like, out to this far. But I am making it all big buildings anywho, because you have to get rid of your smaller buildings to get into a higher population. Just the only way to get around right now. A population cap that's going on. Alright, speed up, guys. Speed up, speed up, speed up, speed up. Half of you are going to stay back. The other half of you are going to be the start of a new population. Or new army of builders, however you want to call it. 6 to 1/2 a dozen. Everyone's like, oh, where'd the light go? I better just build. Look at all my workers. Half of them are glitched out. Half of them are like crackheads. Easily distracted. Not saying crackheads are easily distracted, but fix, and you got it, by all means. They're all eyes. Or all ears, I guess. Now deactivate the beacon here, and these guys should... Whoa, I got a lot of dudes all up in here. Where the heck did you guys come from? Oh no, don't tell me I still have a statue of wandering. Oh man, I think I have a statue of wandering somewhere. I'm gonna have a buttload of dead people. Oh, I'm gonna have so many dead people. Oh no. This is... Hey, B Pilmer! I think I conquered you. Okay, activate my totem. Wait, so you're saying after every time you quit out of the game and reload back into it, your gem strip is back? Are you serious right now? Because I'm so tempted to rock a brand new game. Oh my gosh, that's bullshit. I need the mining capability so badly. Good golly. It's stupid how bad I need this capability. Quickly, men, scatter. Scatter and build. Okay, don't jump off the edge. Okay, you're an idiot. You guys deserve to die. If I had a meteor strike, these guys especially, they'd be dead because they are just ran into a wall and somehow are getting forcibly pushed through, which means they have the equivalent god power of what I have, and so these three people need to die. Everyone else, I guess you can kind of stay. The people who jumped off, this guy's an idiot and doesn't realize he's just got to walk down on the slip and then walk up. So he's going to die. I'm going to let him. He can even walk like this guy. Look at him. Like, dude, I'm a badass. Look at this. I'm a baller. But everything is being built now. I do believe that's all my plots. Finally all built. Don't know why there's a single house here. Oh, no. Game froze again. Oh, golly. Oh, dear. Oh, goodness. Hands off the computer. I'm not touching anything. Great. Super. Now this is what happens when you have too many people doing too many things and you take a look at it. It causes a crash. Sweet, thanks. Oh, I gotta move all my league stuff over to this screen. Let me try to get back up into this Godus. See if I can actually play it. Son of a bitch. Alright, I wanna do a little world view, or not a world view, I wanna do a little PvP. I'm gonna invite the three people that I have on my friends list that are playing Godus. And we can duke it out. Alright, you got 43 peeps. This is bogus. You are... Okay. I will invite... I'll invite one of you guys first here. Or just one at a time. And whoever accepts and wants to play can. Anyone else? Ow, that was loud as fuck. Alright, so they're all... Oh, son of a bitch. No! Don't do this to me, game. Don't do this to me. I'm not going to move. I'm going to load into my game, and I'm going to stay completely still. Everyone, brace yourselves. It's gonna be loud. It's gonna be loud. I'm just not gonna move, and I'm gonna see if my game crashes again. So, yeah, it looks like I got a new game coming up. I am glad that I at least got some video footage of the mountain that I uncovered, which is nice. But, yeah, now there goes my bragging rights. It'd be like, oh hey, I'm the first person to uncover a face. or whatever, and now I'm just gonna lose that. And there goes everyone's ears again. But don't touch anything, don't touch anything. Hopefully everything. Okay? I haven't crashed yet. So as long as I don't move, I'm good. As long as I stay absolutely still until everything's done building, we're good. Yeah, sorry, brace yourself. I think I said. But I gotta wait. I have to let all this build, and then I should be good to move around. But until that, I can't do anything. Oh, I was like, what's that noise? I just heard banging, I didn't realize.
So I saw you over here.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so you just keep going around?
Yeah.
Yeah. My dog's pretty dumb. He's just like, oh, where'd he go? Where'd he go, George? And he just follows. That tee's not going to be good a second time around, man.
I just want to go.
Okay, whatever you say, man. Tee is usually... Okay, hey, that's your call. I'm not a tea drinker. I just hear it's not going to be reheated. That's all I hear, man. Two different things. Well, because you want hot tea. You don't like iced coffee unless it's a caramel macchiato. And it's got to be in a venti. Why be a peasant? No need. True. You're right. I saw that blonde today. Yeah, she wasn't walking this time though. She was just letting her dog go out. My dog was freaking out. I didn't say anything though, I'm a coward. One day.
There was these two chicks who walked into the tea place. Uh-huh. They were like super high in tea
clothes.
Okay. And she's like, finally I've got a job to be high. It's my job to be high. And you know what she was doing?
What?
Walking around holding the signs in a box at the Melbourne Auditorium. That's all she does.
And she's excited about it. Well, good for her. At least she has a job. She gets paid to look pretty. That's... What? I probably won't drink the VA juice. Yeah, I mean, drink it all, man. Just don't pour it out. Oh, yeah, just drink it out of the bottle, man. It's your V8, so... Alright, I should be able to move now. I don't want to risk it. I can't... I would accept your invite, but I can't risk it right now. If I move and my game crashes, what do I lose? Do I just lose the last 10 minutes that I sat here waiting? I mean... I'm clearly running out of... Alright, I'm gonna have to move. Don't memory leak. Oh, thank God. Okay, because as they're building, you have to have enough prayer, gumball, whatever you want for it. So, I have enough. My totem isn't active. But I gotta keep harvesting so that they can keep building. Alright, 5k out of that. Good. Alright, let me see the invite here. Click to join. There we go. I'm searching. I don't know if you're still, Nice! I don't really care. You can pick whatever you want. Big Mountain's fun. As long as we don't do Neighbor. Neighbor is a shiesty map. Alright. Let's do this. Sorry for the crunching that you may hear. starving. So just off the beginning, I'm gonna be rocking red side here. I'm so used to being blue, but I'm just gonna clear away some trees, get some bonus money off of it. And every time I get a population guy to go on out and build, I'm going to. Now, in a population race, you want to have buildings of one.
Yep.
Because that gets you the fastest population. However, oh, I see he's over on my side mining my rocks. And that's the first thing you want to do if you get into the game, is you want to mine the rocks first. It gives you the most, whatever you want to call it, spirituality or faith. Yeah. Oh, I don't want to have two castles. Oh well, I'm going to have a lot of energy. I'm just going to call it energy because that's the easiest thing for me to remember. I'm going to have a buttload. Holy crap. With having so many, I'm going to be able to have some champions out. I'll be able to... Oh, I gotta type real quick. No Godfinger usage. Let me subtract this here. I gotta keep just staying on top of it. Anytime I get a population up, I'm just spawning it out there to let them continuously just build stuff for me. Now, I do want to get a single building in right here, in this spot, as close as I can to the edge, because you'll see in later in the fight as to why I build one house right there, and it's key to my success that I've found when playing against the bots, because this is how, I mean, I've based my multiplayer fighting on the bots, and I just like go super hard and try to beat them as quick as I can. So just keep spawning every time a house comes up. Now, the biggest thing that I'm gonna go and do, I'm gonna farm these rocks here, is there's a huge advantage to getting the hill early. And I'll show you what I mean by that. I'm gonna expand this out here. And now, there's all this land that is available already, so that I don't need to do anything. And all I have to do is build. So getting up here onto the hilltop first allows you to just get your people on out there and continuously build. Now, to activate the totem, and we can get two huge castles. Case, I think he just summoned his guys to go on up to where my guys are, so I'm going to activate my totem again. Kind of summon all the guys that I can muster up here, because there's his totem going up, and you can see he's got his armies. Make sure that all mine are healed as much as possible. I got 400. I don't want to make a settlement yet. I really need some bodies, though. Need some people up here. He's gonna try to fight on my castle, which if I can actually get this castle built, it's gonna be huge for income. Or if he destroys it, which here he goes, he's kind of spreading. Okay, sweet. So he's just gone and built, in which case now if I can get units up here quick enough, I can actually go and attack him while he's building. Because now that he's building, he can't defend, and my guys can get right in here, and, you know, he's kicking my building's ass right now. So if I move my totem here, he's going to send his guys away. It's going to be too late. I'm going to deactivate it. They're going to start fighting. They're going to start building. These guys are already coming up. He's going to come on out. He can probably start building here. Okay, spread this out. Now, what I really gotta do is I need to build in my own area. I need to move this down here. Totem back up here. Let me deactivate it real quick. Let these guys build those few. Collect. Reactivate my totem. I'm gonna actually send my guys up here next. And now what I'm gonna do to this guy is he's unsuspecting. I'm gonna actually block his ability to send more units up, and he won't realize it. So his guys are going to come and look, and they're going to be stuck here. In which case, I don't have enough.
Yo.
If I quickly call my units up, I'll fight him, and I will win the fight.
Yo.
I have 3,000, so I have enough for a swamp.
Yo.
In which case, I'll swamp my own guys. I did kill all of his army, but I did kill all of mine also, which I'm okay with. If I move my totem over to here, quickly heal all my guys that are fighting through this. Deactivate it. I can just build again. Now I want to get my guys up to the north, and if I can, try to do it with this push here. I don't know if he's realized yet that he can't call for backup, because his guys are—they're still stuck. Is he's trying to call in reinforcements? And he doesn't even realize it. In which case, I just have to watch him editing this. And in which case, I'll win the fight, no big deal.
Yep.
Not a thing but a chicken wing. Keep healing my dudes. I want to hit 3,000.
Yo. Okay.
In prayer. So much going on, so much going on. Okay, so I see that he just realized. I'm blocking him in. He's got a lot more units than I do. Holy crap. Okay, I gotta get these guys out of the swamp. I goofed with putting a swamp here. I'm killing my own people. Should have swamped him on the end down here rather than swamping his big army.
Yo. Yep.
But had to do what I had to do, trying it out, no big deal.
Yep.
Ain't a thing but a chicken wing. That's all good. Yeah, he just crushed my castle, holy crap.
Yep.
He's got so many units up here. He's got such a higher population than I do. It's It's like an uphill battle that I know I'm not gonna be able to win straight up. If I can move my totem this way. Not going through the swamp. And here he goes, he's gonna... He's gonna duke it out with me here. Oh no! I tried to block him in, but it didn't work. He's so much bigger than I am. Now, there is balancing issues with this game in the case that you can use Finger of God, and if I used it, I could crush all of his buildings, just spam click and they die. There's nothing he can do about it. He can rebuild them afterwards, but that's it. I'm gonna move my totem here. Activate it. Try to bring my guys up. He's just slowly reinforcing his army. Which hopefully that little move will block him off for a smidgen of time. I have enough now to... Maybe that'll be enough. I'll have to check in a second. I gotta keep harvesting. Keep reinforcing the armies. Yep, so if you look, his people are chilling in swamp. Oh no, he's kicking my dude's butts. He's kicking me. Call me Seymour Butts. I'm gonna see more butts than you, Uncle Tony. Oh, just gotta keep. He's got a huge population lead on me. Holy crack. Oh, we're on a long? We got 47 minutes? This is ridiculous. If I knew I had 47 minutes, I thought this game was over. Alright, I have an idea now. Where did he put his light? He put his light there. So he beautified all of it, in which case... I'm really skeptical to do this, but YOLO. Here we go. This vast population versus mine. Duke it out, bro. Oh no, I destroyed my own building. Keep healing through it all. So much going down. LOLOLOL trollolololol. No. I say no! You go back to where you belong. Stop calling in your reinforcements. You cannot do that.
Okay, yo.
In which case my reinforcements should be running up here. It's so hard in this game, there's not like there's counters for everything. But you have to pay attention to so much, cause like while I'm fighting here, I really could be getting ninja'd in the backside. I could be, you know, he could be building something that I didn't see coming. You know, there's so many options that you can go through and do in this game. Oh shoot, where did that even build? Where did that guy just go? Oh, see? This guy is being a big bonehead. Did he spawn somewhere in the middle? Nope, he didn't spawn BJ Blimper, though.
Yep.
Oh, great, super. So, in which case, these guys are getting mangled hardcore. Oh, I'm getting my butt spanked this game. Duking it out, it's friggin' man mode brawl, every man free for himself here. I can't tell, I don't think anyone else is dying anymore. I think they're all just making love in a big mosh pit. Like no one seems to be dying anymore, so I don't know, I'm gonna take a different approach to this. And see if I can, I don't know, build somewhere. Just get my population to 200. I think you cap at 200 anywho. Or like 210.
Okay. Nope. Yep.
I know you don't, yep. You don't get it that high, that's for dang sure.
Yep. Yep. Yo.
In which case, I'm just gonna start. Doop doo doop doo doo doop. There's another plot. Oh, I won? Wait, what? How did I win? Wait, what? Did his game just crash? Wait. Won by disconnect. Oh man, that sucks. That happened to me last night. I was versing this guy, and all of a sudden I'm like, wait, what just happened? Oh no, my game froze. I just crashed. Hi, Goose. And in which case, all it was, my game was just like,
yep. Okay.
Cool, you lost. I definitely need a rematch here. We gotta do it for 15 minutes. We had it on fast game speed. We gotta set it on slow. Kindling is garbage. Oh, sandstone. Alright, that's a keeper. Yeah, I got one. So that's good. Oh, okay, I got two, actually. Okay, sweet.
Yeah.
Alright. Yeah, I know, I got it. Not for what I need it in, unfortunately. But I'll take it. A useful card is better than not a useful card, so anything that kind of forwards me to that progression of the Bronze Age. Ow! Yeah, you make lots of weird noises, don't you, Goose? Now look at this. Look at this city. Oh, it's so sexy. So busy with people. It's all connected. All right, all in worship for Princess Diana. For old Helen. For Athena. Whatever you want. In time, maybe, or but does anyone have comments other than me totally sucking eggs at fighting? I was doing good last night, but man, I couldn't get it right for me today. What are you doing with your big old blockhead? You got a massive noggin. Your head is huge. You can't have any pretzels. Mm-mm. No pretzels for the puppy. Now your head's stuck. because you had a sticker out of my lap. Your head is now stuck. Now I'm going to pet the top of your dome. Now I'm going to pet the top of your head. Okay, get out of here. Get out of here, I'm done with you. Get out of here. No, move your face. No, quit nuzzling. Get out of here. Okay. Yeah, no problem, man. You have a good night. Thanks for tuning in. So anytime you want a battle, just let me know. Alright, I'll grab you a photo of my dog here. Uh-oh, that goes the lid. Let me... Do-do-do-do-do. iPhone photos. Let's see what we got here. Let's see if I can find a cute one. So this is him in the morning. He's all sad, like, oh, what did I do? And then you got this one where he's just laying down. He's giving him some pets. Well, that's robots, so they'll take over our future. Let me see. I got a bunch here. Maybe he's getting his belly all rubbed. He's like, oh yeah, that's nice. I like that. He's 2 years old. Oh, soon to be two in a few days, actually. But, yeah, he's an adorable little thing. This is him. When I watch shows, I put my bed up against my computer, which is just a cot for now since I just moved down to Florida. But, I blocked him off and he just looked at me like, really? Really? I can't snuggle next to you? Take a look here. Let's see what you got with your dog here. Rob Drum. Oh, look at that. Sweet. Dog's just standing at like attention. I gotta decide. Now, yo, I'll fight you. I'll fight you. Let's go. Let you invite. I got you. If you wanna fight, anyways. I hope. That's the goal, is to be mining by tomorrow. Otherwise, I'm just going to restart. I'm going to save this file because I have the statue all revealed, which is cool. And, yeah, just start mining. Hey, man. I'll fight anybody. I'll take it easy if you want. I'll just kind of mess around and actually perfect a strategy on fighting. If you want. If you want to do that, I'll take it easy. We'll play like neighbor map, the neighbor one. In which case, it's not really like going and killing. It's kind of building and strategizing. Kind of do that. All right. If you don't want me to take it easy, I'm just gonna try and stop you. I'll just be frank with you. I'm just gonna come up and spank your booty and imagine I have a big paddle and you've been a bad boy and I'm gonna spank you. And that's not in a kinky way, that's in like a father spanking his son for doing something bad kind of way. So, dog, you can't have any pretzels. No, cheddar pretzels for you are going to end up coming out your rear the wrong way. And I don't want to have to pick with that up yesterday, whatever. Uh-oh. We can't have any. Don't look at me, because I'm not going to give you none. Mm-mm. Not a single one. I will, however... Uh-oh. My game just froze. What the heck? Where's my cursor? Uh-oh. Oh, golly. What just happened? Why did my whole screen just reset? Why did Arrow's theme just kick in? Oh, my goodness. Display driver stopped. Huh. So, the game just crashed my graphics card? Guarded region heap 0. Okay, what? What just happened? I'm so confused. Wait, why does it say... Test. Why is it, what the heck?